All right, so what you're gonna need is a synthesizer that has MIDI via USB. I do, and I plugged in a cable already, and I sent that to my computer. Then I took an audio jack cable, and I plugged that into my audio interface on channel 1. Internally, I chose MIDI channel 1 on my synth. And then when I go to my MIDI settings, I choose my circuit station, that's my synth, and I choose port 1. Now, once you've done that, you're going to click up here, and then you're going to add what's called the MIDI out plugin. I already did that, and that one is here. And that's not what you want to see. You want to see, sorry, that was this here. It's kind of hard looking through the camera, but you click on your MIDI out part, and voila. You see this weird interface that totally makes no sense. But if you choose port 1 upstairs, it should work, because now, and of course, important to note is that you need to dedicate a channel on your mixer where the audio comes in. So when I choose channel 1, the audio comes in. Now all you have to do is make a loop down here, click here, and you create a whole loop of MIDI notes on your piano roll. As you can see, I already made something that's going to be the lead sound. Now when you click record, it's going to say, what do you want to do? And I say, everything. And then when you click play, it should record this part that I programmed. So let's see. And since I only did one pattern here with the MIDI notes, it only records one pattern, which is 64 steps. Now, I cut off that tail because nobody's going to use that tail. Bam, you got a clean loop. Now you disarm the record button again, you should be good. And if I isolate that track and just play that one solo, and as you can tell, I've turned down the volume on this, so nothing is playing here. It's all in your computer now. And now you don't need the MIDI anymore because it's already recorded. So that way you can record a bass, a lead, pluck, an arp, whatever you want, and whatever your synthesizer allows, of course. So have fun.